Today's pretty cool because we're starting a new segment for you. It's called Thrifty Thursday, and we're showing you how to feed a family of six for under $10.
Yeah, pretty incredible. Yeah. You may recognize our guest, though. She's from the hit TLC show Extreme Couponing, Jessica Hacker, who also lives right here in the Treasure Valley. Jessica, thanks for joining us.
Of course. Thank you for having me.
Here in the Treasure Valley.
Yeah. No, it's great to be able to share it because it's easy to do.
And it's good information for everybody, yeah.
It is. You don't even have to coupon to do this.
So. Oh, pretty cool.
So what are we making today? This is this is just under $10. I saw all the breakdown that you sent us, and we'll have some of this coming up on the screen as well. What can you possibly make for under $10 that's going to feed a family?
I know. You can make a lot. So I have a big family. I have a family of six. Okay. Three of them are teenage boys, and trust me, any of you that have actually seen them, they're big. So it can happen. And this meal here, you're not even couponing. Granted, if you are couponing, it's going to be even cheaper.
Wow.
But this one we're doing pulled pork sandwiches with a spicy coleslaw and grilled fries. And then even reusing all of our leftovers and making a second meal out of that, that'll also be under $10.
Wow, sounds good. So what do we do?
So it's super easy. It's amazing. These picnic pork roasts are so cheap, and they're the best way to go. This one you can pick up $1.48 a pound. That's very normal for them.
Just
so
at any grocery store,
really,
you got to go look specifically at a certain place for it?
No, really anywhere. That's what it's going to cost. Granted, this entire meal came from Ridley's, which has an amazing deal going on, so I would recommend going there. But yeah, they have them on sale for $1.48 a pound. You're just going to put this in the crock pot. Of course, you want to do fat side up so it'll absorb into it. Throw it in your crock pot on low for 8 hours. Seasoning wise, just put 2 cups of water and whatever you have in your pantry. That's the idea of being frugal about it, whether it's garlic, fruit juice, anything, even a pop goes really great on it.
Huh. Okay.
And let it cook down. Then make your sandwiches. The coleslaw is easy. Obviously, doing it yourself, shredding everything, is going to save you a fortune. You know, you can buy a head of cabbage for right around 50 cents a pound.
Cabbage is super cheap.
It is very cheap.
I noticed that. I don't eat it a lot, but the last couple times we've bought it, I was kind of surprised wondering why we didn't eat it more, because it's super cheap.
It is. It's super cheap. It has great flavor, and it's good for you. Doing it that way, it's a lot cheaper. One head of cabbage would equal about 2 bags of already shredded, which is going to cost you right around $2-$3 a bag. So you're saving a fortune by doing it that way.
Okay.
Same as the carrots. Shred them yourself. And this recipe is easy. It's not a cream-based one, so it's great for you, really low in calories. It's just your head of cabbage, a bunch of cilantro. Granted, if you have a garden, you're going to save even more.
Yeah, good idea.
Yep, just shred everything, throw it in.
And so this is the finished product here then today, since you said it's not cream-based?
Yep, okay. Yep, it's not cream-based, so it's just got a vinegar in it is what it
Delicious.
Is. And then your potatoes. The potatoes are super cheap. And again, buying a whole bag of potatoes, I mean, this 10-pound bag of potatoes cost me $1.50.
Like you said it was about 8 cents a potato is
it
all,
is.
Right?
Yeah, I mean, in a 10-pound bag, you're going to have about 20 potatoes in there. Yeah, so they end up being about 8 cents a potato. And so that's $1.50, and that's really at most that you're going to spend. Usually you'll get a bag like that for around $1, even cheaper, especially when we're getting into the holidays.
Awesome.
So yeah, 4 potatoes, and that's a lot of potatoes really when you cut it into fries.
Mm-hmm.
So I like to just put it on a cookie sheet. I use foil because I don't like to do dishes, so do that. It saves you time. Spray it with some nonstick spray or olive oil, throw it on the grill, and just cook them on each side till they're nice and crispy.
Okay. And do you do any seasonings on those?
I do.
Recommendations?
Yeah, you know, whatever you feel like. I personally love garlic salt, but maybe some just want, you know, do some pepper on them or just some normal salt.
And we are going to put these recipes on our website.
Yes.
And you're coming every Thursday, by the way, so
good
news there. Quickly, what is the, I guess, the rewind?
Yeah, so good. I like to call it a rewind. The idea is to reuse and find another purpose for it.
So sounds better than leftovers.
It is. Yeah, my family hates leftovers. I have to make it something completely different. So for this recipe, you're only going to use half of this roast, about 4 pounds of it, to make the sandwiches. You're going to use the other half of it to make a rewind, which would be pulled pork stuffed baked potatoes. And they are amazing.
They sound amazing.
They are really great. Yeah, so you can use your leftover pulled pork that's got the barbecue sauce in it, throw in a potato with some cheese. Again, it's always going to be cheaper to buy a brick of cheese and shred it yourself. That 2 pounds cost me $4 with coupons. Otherwise, it'll cost you $5. I'm going to get 8 cups of shred, where a bag is going to cost you about $3, and you're only going to get 2 cups, maybe 2 cups.
Wow.
Okay. So it's, yes.
So set aside some time. I'll take you some time, because you're going to be shredding the coleslaw ingredients, the cheese, that kind of stuff. But it really does save you a lot of money if you think about how many bags you buy over time if you don't do the block yourself.
This is great, that prep. Think about what you want for the week. Ridley's does a great program called Fill It Fresh, and that's where this bag, all of that produce there, I stuffed into that bag. And it's, you fill that bag for $10. So I've got 16 items I was able to put in that bag. It breaks down to a little over 60 cents an item.
Wow. So. All right. Well, Jessica, thanks so much. We'll put all of this information on our website.
This
is without coupons. If you want more on couponing, livingonacoupon.com.